Investigators say Michael Dunn told them he felt threatened, and that's why he started shooting last Friday night.
The 45-year-old Brevard County man is awaiting extradition to Jacksonville, where police say he fired 8 or 9 times into an SUV at a gate gas station, killing 17-year-old Jordan Davis, a student at Wilson High School. According to police, Dunn and Davis got into a confrontation over loud music. Channel 4's Jason Law has been following the investigation. He's joining us now with more on what we've learned about Dunn. Jason?
Mary, one of the things we learned from investigators today is that the suspect in this case, Michael Dunn, is a gun enthusiast. He collects guns, and he's been known to go and take his guns and fire them off at a shooting range near his home in Brevard County. Now, one of the things that investigators told us, and one of the questions we had for investigators, was if anything significant in Dunn's life may have set him off or provoked him into Friday night shooting. And investigators today told us they didn't know of any such event. Jacksonville police say Michael Dunn was in town Friday, attending his son's wedding. Around 7:40, he pulled into the gate station off of Southside Boulevard and parked next to an SUV. Inside sat 17-year-old Jordan Davis. Police say Dunn and Davis began arguing about the volume of the music coming from the teen's SUV.
Our suspect, Michael Dunn, made a comment for them to turn the music down. Evidently, there was words exchanged between our victim, who was sitting in the back seat of that vehicle, and our suspect.
According to police, Dunn pulled out a gun and shot into the SUV 8 or 9 times. Davis was hit more than once and killed.
That once all the facts come out, what really happened is made known, that it will be very clear that Mr. Dunn acted responsibly and as any responsible firearms owner would have acted under these same circumstances.
Michael Dunn is from Satellite Beach, about 170 miles from Jacksonville. Police say he was with his girlfriend at the time of the shooting. Police didn't identify her Monday, but said she wouldn't face any charges. Investigators said there were 2 other 17-year-olds and an 18-year-old in the SUV. They were not hurt.
They were listening to the music. It was loud. They admitted that. But, I mean, that's not a reason for someone to open fire.
Just a few minutes ago, we got reaction from Jordan Davis's father, Ron Davis, who said that he was told that Dunn will actually be back in Jacksonville as soon as tomorrow to face those murder charges here. Moved from Brevard County to Jacksonville as soon as tomorrow. He says he has no reaction to the arrest. He just misses his son tonight. We're live on the South Side. Jason Law, Channel 4, the local station.
Now, Jason, as you told us, police say Dunn told them he felt threatened, and that's why he opened fire. Police say if there were any weapons in the SUV?
The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office told me today, Mary, that there was no gun in the teen's vehicle. There were 4 teens in that SUV that Dunn is accused of shooting into. Jason says no guns in that car, so if Dunn was threatened, it was by something other than a gun. His son's wedding. Around 7:40, he pulled into the gate station off of Southside Boulevard and parked next to an SUV. Inside sat 17-year-old Jordan Davis. Police say Dunn and Davis began arguing about the volume of the music coming from the teen's SUV.
Our suspect, Michael Dunn, made a comment for them to turn the music down. Evidently, there was words exchanged between our victim, who was sitting in the back seat of that vehicle, and our suspect.
According to police, Dunn pulled out a gun and shot into the SUV 8 or 9 times. Davis was hit more than once and killed.
That once all the facts come out, what really happened is made known, that it will be very clear that Mr. Dunn acted responsibly and as any responsible firearms owner would have acted under these same circumstances.
Michael Dunn is from Satellite Beach, about 170 miles from Jacksonville. Police say he was with his girlfriend at the time of the shooting. Police didn't identify her Monday, but said she wouldn't face any charges. Investigators said there were 2 other 17-year-olds and an 18-year-old in the SUV. They were not hurt.
They were listening to the music. It was loud. They admitted that. But, I mean, that's not a reason for someone to open fire.
Just a few minutes ago, we got reaction from Jordan Davis's father, Ron Davis. Mary, one of the things we learned from investigators today is that the suspect in this case, Michael Dunn, is a gun enthusiast. He collects guns, and he's been known to go and take his guns and fire them off at a shooting range near his home in Brevard County. Now, one of the things that investigators told us, and one of the questions we had for investigators, was if anything significant in Dunn's life may have set him off or provoked him into Friday night shooting. And investigators today told us they didn't know of any such event. Jacksonville police say Michael Dunn was in town Friday attending.
Investigators say Michael Dunn told them he felt threatened, and that's why he started shooting last Friday night.
The 45-year-old Brevard County man is awaiting extradition to Jacksonville, where police say he fired 8 or 9 times into an SUV at a Gate gas station, killing 17-year-old Jordan Davis, a student at Wilson High School. According to police, Dunn and Davis got into a confrontation over loud music. Channel 4's Jason Law has been following the investigation. His story is now with more on what we've learned about Dunn. Jason?